Hello everybody, Teagan here with High Point. Thank you so much for tuning in to tonight's episode of What is in the Night Sky this month. Tonight I'm going to be taking you through a beautiful tour of the night sky in the month of February. We're going to take a look at several deep sky objects. We're going to see what the moon and the planets are up to. So as always, buckle in and let's see what's really out there. Alright, so before we venture out farther into our galaxy and past our galaxy, we're gonna stick around and see what our nearest neighbors are up to. Saturn will be lost to the glare of the sun by mid-month, but a thin crescent moon appears to the lower left of it shortly after sunset on February 10th. Neptune is too faint and low for proper observation, but Jupiter remains easily visible in the evening sky. Look for a beautiful crescent moon to the lower right of the planet on the 14th. Uranus is further east and spends the month within the same binocular field of view of the star Botein. Meanwhile, Venus is an unmissable sight in the pre-dawn twilight at the beginning of the month, but is harder to spot by the month's end. It's joined by a gorgeous crescent moon on February 7th, with Mars also appearing to the lower left. The gap between the two planets will close until less than a degree separates them from the 21st to the 23rd. Mercury, on the other hand, is only visible for the first week of February, and you'll find it 3.5 degrees to the lower left of Mars on February 1st. As for the moon, it turns new on the 9th, and the full snow moon occurs on the 24th. Now we're going to move on past our solar system, further out into our galaxy, and we're going to take a look at Aristotle's cluster, Messier 41. Messier 41 can be spotted with the naked eye under dark skies, but otherwise is an easy target for both binoculars and telescopes, even from suburban locations. You'll find it just 4 degrees due south of Sirius, placing it within the same binocular field of one of the brightest stars in the night sky. The cluster shows a definite shape through 10x50 binoculars, with a circular hole being apparent on the cluster's western edge. Now, our next target in February is another cluster, but one that is simply spectacular through a telescope. NGC 2362 may be smaller than neighboring Messier 41 that we just talked about, but it is brighter and telescopes can produce a beautiful view. A low magnification will show Tau Canis Majoris, a brilliant blue-white star appearing just off-center and surrounded by a swarm of fainter stars. This cluster is also known as the Northern Jewel Box, and for a good reason. These are young stars, perhaps only a million years old, making NGC 2362 one of the youngest star clusters known. It lies at a distance of roughly 5,000 light years and thought to be around 7 light years in diameter. This jewel box cluster is gorgeous through telescopes with an eyepiece, and also for those who like photographing open star clusters, this is a beautiful one for the cameras. We are going to stick with open clusters for the beginning and through the middle of this tour, and we're going to take a look at Messier 93. This cluster is located in the constellation of Puppis. M93 lies just a degree and a half northwest of Asmodiski. I think I've pronounced that one right. A magnification of around 35 times shows a dense cluster of stars with a pair of orangish stars on the western edge. This cluster lies just 6 degrees due east of the previous cluster, NGC 2362. A small telescope will show this cluster well, with a vast majority of these stars being blue and white. As we leave Messier 93, we're going to move to the last deep sky object on this list, and also it's the last star cluster, Messier 35. Through binoculars, this cluster appears as an hourglass-shaped gray misty patch of uniform brightness, while a telescope will show hundreds of blue-white stars. Look out for a golden star on the northern edge of the cluster with a blue star quite close to it. Although it's not bright enough to be seen with the naked eye, it can easily be found with binoculars. To locate it, draw a line through Alnitak, the easternmost star in Orion's belt, and Betelgeuse, the coppery star that marks the shoulder of the Hunter. Now, I said that Messier 35 was the last deep sky object on our list, but we do have one more object, and it's technically a star, but it's not just any star, it's a very well-known, it is a famous star. It goes by the name of Castor. Castor is one of the best multiple stars in the entire night sky. A small telescope and a magnification of around 100 times will show a tight pair of brilliant white stars, with one star being slightly brighter than the other. There are a number of fascinating sights for amateur astronomers in the constellation of Gemini, and Castor is one of these. Alright, so that is our tour of the night sky in the month of February. We thank you so much for staying tuned. If you have ever seen or photographed any of these beautiful open clusters, please let us know. We would love to hear your experience viewing them through the eyepiece. If you haven't already, like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel so you do not miss any future content on astronomy or astrophotography. With that being said, thank you so much, and clear skies.